All right, ready?
Mm-hmm.
As ready as I'll ever be, Brian.
Yeah, I'm ready.
I'm ready for you, big boy.
What's going on, guys? I'm Brian from the Stuff Club.
Yeah.
We got Mike, Jesse, and Jennifer, and we are going to be trying something new here, and we are doing the Stuff Club Roundtable, or as I was calling it, the film reel. Pretty cool name. Today we're
like going to
be we're going to be discussing our favorite summer blockbusters. So basically, any big time movie that came out in the summer that made a whole bunch of money. So
money.
Just to start us off,
something I'll go Mike first. Never seems to have enough of.
Just these money.
But, at least I know how to shove 5 Oreos in my mouth, Jesse. Jeez. Put the whole Oreo in your mouth. Slowly.
How many Oreos can Jesse fit in his mouth?
Yeah. Over, under 5.
Look, I'm going with over.
I'm saying at least 5. Like, on, stacking them.
Whole ass
get
Oreos,
there.
Jesse.
Get over there.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Shove them in, big boy.
Get them in there.
I don't
open wide. Here comes the Cookie Express. No, put them in long ways.
One by one.
They didn't all fit, you fool. One by one.
Get to do one and stack.
What are you new? You put them in like one and you pack it in and two and you pack it in.
We are going to be discussing summer blockbusters. And I'll go first. My favorite summer blockbuster of all time is The Dark Knight.
So what are you proposing?
It's simple. Kill the Batman. Here's my card.
What year did that come out?
Came out in July of 2008. Obviously starring Christian Bale as Batman, Bruce Wayne, Heath Ledger's the Joker. Honestly, it's probably my favorite movie of all time. I've always loved that movie. I know that most of you are big time superhero fans, big time Batman fans, and to me, that's the best summer blockbuster of all time.
Debatable, but we'll go with that.
Debatable.
Yeah, very.
I've never seen it.
I saw that movie 7 times in the theaters.
Oh wow!
Yeah,
it looked too dark for me.
It's definitely one of the better Batmans.
Honestly, though, after rewatching it a few times, if Heath Ledger was never in that movie as the Joker, as Mike is looking for, he looks like a bird. Mike, why do you look like a bird?
I'm looking for something.
He's probably looking for a prop to show. Like,
Thought he was looking for his dignity.
Some Batman. For me, though, I don't think I've actually seen a whole Batman movie. Growing up, I was into Batman, like the cartoons. So, Batman Beyond, is that the one where the intro is all like black and red? Yeah. That one was good. Like, I saw that,
yep.
But I don't know. When a lot of the Batman movies came out, me personally, I was like, I'm not sure if I want to watch it or not. Is that the one where the pencil disappears in the forehead? I've heard.
Yeah, the magic. Okay.
Yeah.
Tryouts. Tryouts.
I recently rewatched it, and that movie sucks without Heath Ledger in it. It really does. It's a terrible
movie without
Heath Ledger in it.
Yeah.
The Joker made that movie. Not saying that Christian Bale's a bad actor, because he's not even close. But his Batman is probably the worst.
Christian Batman Bale's? I've ever seen. Christian Bale's Batman's the worst?
Ooh, yes, Christian Bale's
Batman
is the worst.
Brian, you're talking my language here. Who's the best Batman?
You're going to hate this one, Ben Affleck.
Is there any question?
Ben Affleck, you think, is the best Batman?
Ben Affleck is the best Batman.
Brian chose wisely. He's allowed in my house now.
You guys are delusional. I'm telling you that now.
Who's the best Batman?
Michael Keaton.
Adam West. No doubt.
You're smoking. That's why he's your favorite.
Oh, Jesus.
But, wait,
he's not my favorite. Michael Keaton. That was a good Batman. That's my favorite. No, but Adam West, best Batman.
Mm. We'll get into the Batman debate in a different episode.
Yeah, there's a lot I feel like to talk about that.
Oh, yeah.
The storyline of it, though, the action, and how it basically leaves on a cliffhanger ending is just why it's such a good movie to me. And then they really messed it up when they made The Dark Knight Rises, because The Dark Knight Rises was a terrible way to end that series.
Yeah.
It was not a good movie at all.
There it is.
That's what he was looking for.
That's what you were looking for? That's what you were looking for?
Oh, that's got the Jim Carrey one in it, too.
Yeah. Yeah. It's got Batman, the Michael Keaton Batman.
Yep.
Nice.
But so that's my favorite summer blockbuster. Let's go to Jennifer next.
Okay, this one was hard, honestly. I'm actually going to choose one that I never saw in theaters. The Lion King, the original animation that came out June 24th, 1994.
We are all connected in the great circle of life.
And I feel like that I've spent so much money on the merchandise over the years. It's one of my favorites. And I know, like, we probably all can pick something from our childhood for the best summer blockbuster, but I don't know. I feel like as an adult watching different movies, yes, I can pick one, but looking at it as a whole, I would say The Lion King, probably. Plus, I wanted to be more different than what you guys would probably pick. To have some variety, too.
Was the original still better than the remake? Because I never saw the remake.
Well, yes. The original has a different tone. It's classic. It's 2D animation, too. That's my favorite animation. The live action was pretty cool how they did like shot per shot in some of the scenes. However, I felt like areas that I was kind of nitpicking at and wish they would have copied or did something like the original. So I do say the original is better, even though the live action one last summer made a crap ton of money and it was still cool to see, but I still say hands down the original outbeats it.
Ooh.
Yeah.
The original is pretty good. The original animated compared to the action new one. I do enjoy that one. I enjoy watching Mufasa beg, Scar, help me, brother. Me.
I had.
Not live the king.
I brother, had that figurine me. That help you me, used. Brother.
We're messed up individuals.
Well, I haven't watched that movie in so long. And I even have Disney Plus, and I just have not watched it.
Here's the thing, though. On Disney Plus, it's probably going to be the remastered version. When Disney remasters their 2D animation movies, I feel like there's a different quality to it. They're trying to make it nice and clean and crisp. But I still feel like the original is where it's at, because a lot of people say if you watch the remastered versions, it's going to look weird because it looks almost too...
Yeah, too vibrant and crisp.
Too vibrant. There's also a thing that when they clean up the artwork or the cells, however they do the remastering, that they're actually missing like some of the lines or some of the work that was put into the art of it. Yeah, we might do that for 25 Days of Disney about that, so I don't want to get too into it, but I say, like, the original before they remastered it is probably the best way to watch
VHS
it.
Version.
Yes, VHS.
Yeah.
Oh, it's like George Lucas remastering all the Star Wars and everybody hates it.
20 times.
40 times.
Here's Empire Strikes Back with, like, 20 different endings, 20 different visual remasters, different soundtracks.
You know what needs a remaster and just be a completely different movie? Oh, the last three trilogy movies. But we'll get into that too.
Back to Lion King. Plus, it just has an amazing soundtrack. So I feel like having an amazing soundtrack along with how beautiful the artwork was, and just, you know, how great the movie was, I feel like that really puts it up high too.
Elton John, that Elton John music, though. It's good.
Was it Elton John?
Yes.
Yeah.
Oh, I forgot it was Elton John.
Sure was.
And it's sad. Billy Joel does the singing.
Wow.
I didn't know that. Why Should I Worry? But with the Lion King live action, I don't think they asked Elton John to come in on board. I read an article somewhere that Elton John, I don't think he was too happy about that. That Disney didn't even ask him to come.
No,
I feel like that was kind of
like
a slap in the face. Like, come on.
Did the new song? Was it Beyonce that did the Elton John song redo?
Queen Bee. Yep.
Yeah, didn't like it.
There was a lot of people involved in it.
Okay. I think we should move on to
yeah.
Let's leave Mike for last. Jesse, what's yours?
Wow.
So, what are we qualifying summer? Like, what?
Any movie that came out in the summer. Brian has a stipulation. Like, Brian's like, you can't do May because that's still spring.
Yep.
May can count because there's a lot of movies that's listed during May.
Yeah. That's why I was, like, wondering, like, are we going to start it?
Well, I mean, I guess it.
Summer starts?
I guess it depends on what, what state you live in because it's hot all the time.
Yeah.
Wow.
Like California, hot all the time. Florida, hot all the time.
Why? What movie did you have in mind that came out in May? Is that what you're going towards?
Yep.
What is it?
And Mike knows it's one of my favorite movies of all time, too.
God, he's going to say The Crow.
Oh, yeah. Damn right.
It's a good movie.
You know, my daddy used to say, every man's got a devil. You can't rest till you find him.
Winked at me before he jumped out a fourth-floor window like he had wings.
Never seen it. Never seen it.
It's a good movie.
You guys are living under a rock.
The Crow is for goths that want a superhero movie. Am I not wrong,
necessarily?
Though?
As not Brian picks up.
Prop time with Brian. What's he got in his garage this time?
Probably way too much shit.
What about The Crow?
All the good things about that movie on top of bad things.
Yeah, the credits.
The main thing.
Go on.
Which credits?
The end credits. Because the movie's over.
Mike, you never say it. You can't even say if it's good or not.
Oh, fair enough.
You really can't? Yeah, so Mike's they probably out. Had one of the most
go on
star-ridden cast, like as a main actor, that had a lot of potential. Because honestly, if he would have lived after that movie, he would have had a lot more potential than what he did in that movie.
I've never seen it.
You're talking about Bruce Lee's kid, right?
Yeah, Brandon Lee. Yeah. So, Ryan. There's that on top of, they actually made 5 movies of it, which is kind of mind-boggling.
They made the 5 of those movies?
Yeah, the 5th one was trash.
Ooh.
Like, bad. Like, indie film, C-grade trash.
Ouch.
Yeah, it was down there.
Damn.
The best two are probably the first one.
The first one and the second one?
The Crow, no, the third one.
Third one.
Mm-hmm.
Damn.
Because
any of them.
They all had different actors for the main guy.
Oh,
that's why. Yeah.
Well, how much did The Crow, like, did that make, like, a lot of money?
I just had it pulled up, actually. $50.70 million.
Jesus.
And the Rotten Tomatoes on it is 82% fresh.
I don't trust Rotten Tomatoes worth a damn. So, but I've seen parts and bits of the movie. I haven't seen the full thing all the way through though. What's his name? Is it Jason Lee? No,
Brandon Lee.
Brandon Lee.
He was a really good actor. It sucked the way that he died too, especially since it was supposed to be a prop gun. And he actually got shot with a real bullet, or it came unlodged. The cap came unlodged and went through him.
Yeah, pretty much.
But he did have a lot of potential, and the actual story of The Crow is very interesting because it's basically how they portrayed Catwoman in in Batman because he dies and then he comes back because of something. I can't remember what it was, mm-hmm. though. But they do the same thing in Batman Returns with Catwoman, how she dies, but she has 9 lives.
Yeah, because she's randomly, a cat.
Yeah.
Meow.
Not the garbage Catwoman that came out in 2004 with Halle Berry, but...
Michelle Pfeiffer.
Michelle Pfeiffer, that's her name. But yep. It's a good movie. It's a very fun movie to watch from what I remember. Okay, Mike.
I mean...
Hey, you ready for this?
He's we all know what it's like, going to be.
The remake Star Wars, one of those.
What's going to be, Jennifer? What's going to be?
Avengers.
Nope.
Oof. If it's a mystery man, I'm going to shoot you.
I swear, if it's any of the newer 3 Star Wars movies, I'm smacking you.
Why? I'm shocked it's not Avengers.
Because Avengers came out back in May.
But Avengers counts, though.
Yeah.
It's the 2007, released on July 3rd, 2007, directed by Michael Bay, live-action Transformers movie.
Oh, God. Well, the first one's good.
The first one's
good. Yeah.
Yeah.
It's a robot. You know, like a super advanced robot. It's probably Japanese.
I like the person. I like the first one because it's my childhood right there on the big screen.
Yeah, pretty much.
In live action. You can't get much better than that than freaking Optimus Prime fighting Megatron, and then you got Shia LaBeouf showing just exactly how great of an actor he actually is.
And didn't they have Jetfire in that one?
And you got Bumblebee, you got Bernie Mac, you got Megan Fox.
Don't they have Jetfire in that one? Or was that
the
second one?
That's the second one, Revenge of the Fallen.
That's what I was thinking.
Yeah.
After one, they all went down the tubes.
They find Megatron, and Megatron's
slowly.
The Hoover Dam in, was it Las Vegas?
I think.
Nevada,
and the All-Star Cube brings him back to life, and they gotta find Megatron. Now, that's my favorite, live-action Transformers movie out of, the original saga, but the best live-action adaptation of Transformers will always be Bumblebee.
Yes.
I never saw that one. I wanted to see it.
They use the G1 bot models in it, and it's so good.
Yeah.
I haven't seen any of the Transformer movies.
That's okay. You really don't need to.
We need to just, set up a weekend where I'm not working or anything like that, and just have a movie marathon all weekend.
This is unbelievable. I can't believe I've never seen any of the Transformers movies, Jennifer.
It's treason.
This is treason,
Jennifer. Sorry. You're not missing anything. You're the first one. The first one you should probably watch, but the rest
wait, isn't Josh
Duhamel?
Yes.
Yes.
Is he in it?
He is.
Uh-huh. I would watch it just for him.
Yeah, he's and Tyrese.
I would watch Transformers just for Josh.
My man Tyrese.
Oh God.
But no, I like them. They're really good movies. Linkin Park did the some of the songs for them, like the first 3 of them or whatever it was.
I think it's This Is the End and a couple others.
It's What I've Done, Jesse. But that was
no in the end. In the end.
In the end. No, yeah. That was from a different album.
Was it?
Yes. Yes, sir. But no, I definitely recommend watching the live-action Transformers movie, but hands down, the best Transformers movie, will always be the 1984 animated Transformers movie.
Does it sound Blockbuster?
Probably.
What I've Done, Doomsday Clock, The Moment, Before It's Too Late. They actually got a lot of good songs on that soundtrack. Holy shit.
That's a banger, dude.
Yeah.
Did you cry? They got Prime died?
Smashing Pumpkins, Disturbed, Linkin Park.
Did you cry when Optimus Prime died?
Brian, that's not in the first one.
Huh? I'm talking about the old one.
Oh, the dude. Original?
Yeah.
Dude, who didn't cry? You're heartless. You two are heartless sons.
I mean, what do you expect?
Optimus Prime dies in the original, and then Ultra Magnus has to take over as leader of the Autobots.
I completely forgot Ultra Magnus existed.
Or is it? It's Magnus Prime, I think it was. But that's the point. That's the topic for another video.
Yeah, you've seen every Transformers movie though.
Sure have. I've seen
first three.
All right, that's it for this one. Stay tuned for the next one, and the one after that. Hopefully, next time we don't get Brian nipping it.
He got the pliers too.
We're losing Brian, but I'm like.
He's gone.
That's the ending. Like, comment, subscribe for more. Okay, bye. Oh God, he's on top of
okay, bye.
Where'd the little guy go?